शुक्लाम्बरधरं विष्णुं शशिवर्णं चतुर्भुजं प्रसन्नवदनं ध्यायेत सर्वविघ्नोपशान्तये। श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादशङ्करं लोकशङ्करम्। नमस्ते। Now we will see the meanings of Shri Vishnu Sahasranama based on Shri Shankaracharya Bhashya for verse 75. First, we will see the verse. Sadgatis satkritis satta sadbhutis satparayanaha shuraseno yadushreshtaha sannivasasuyamunaha. The namas herein are Sadgatihi, Satkritihi, Satta, Sadbhutihi, Satparayanaha, Shurasenaha, Yadushreshtaha, Sannivasaha, Suyamunaha. There are 9 namas herein. We will see the meanings of each of these one by one. The first nama is Sadgatihi. अस्ति ब्रह्मेति चेद्वेद संतमेनन्ततो विदुरिति इति श्रुतेः। ब्रह्मास्तीति ये विदुः ते संतः तैः प्राप्यते इति सद्गतिः। ब्रह्मन् एग्जिस्ट्स् इफ दस वन नोस ही इज नोन एज सत द वर्चुअस दस स्टेट द वेदस द वन हु इज अटेन्ड बाय सच वर्चुअस is Sadgatihi. So the nama Sadgatihi has two components, Sat and Gati. Gati means the one who is attained, Prapyate. So Bhagavan is the one who is attained. So who attain him or by whom is he attained? Sadbhihi, Taihi Sadbhihi. So by the Sat means those noble, wise and virtuous, the one who is attained by them, he is Sadgatihi. So, who are noble, wise and virtuous? The Vedas themselves clarify that asti brahmeti chedveda, the one who understands that Brahman exists. Brahman exists as the substratum of the entire creation. It is from the Satchidananda Brahma that everything is created. So the world is not created just from a void or just by a chance. It is from the conscious substratum that the world has emerged. So those who are aware of this, those who know this, they are called as Sat. Means santamenam tato viduriti. They are known as virtuous, wise and knowledgeable. So the one who is attained by those who clearly understand that there exists a conscious substratum of this creation, so he is Sadgatihi. There is another interpretation given to this by Acharya. Sati gatihi buddhihi samutkrishta asyeti va Sadgatihi. The one whose intellect is transcendental, sublime and supreme. So he is Sadgatihi. So here in the second interpretation, the word Gatihi means intellect. Gatihi, Buddhihi. So how is the intellect of the Bhagavan? Samutkrishta, transcendental, sublime, supreme. So the workings of the mind or the intellect of the Bhagavan is unfathomable. So his mind boggling. He manages the vast, variegated universe, and each and every jivatman who seeks his grace is granted the blessings and grace. So in this way, a person who has such an intellect by which he manages such a vast and varied universe and all the individuals therein, so he is Sadgatihi, the one, the mighty, great intellect. The next nama is Satkritihi. Sati Kritihi Jagadrakshana Lakshana Yasya Tena Satkritihi. The one whose actions are virtuous in the form of protection of the universe. So Sat and Kriti are the two components of this nama. Kriti is action and Sat is noble and wise. So Kriti, so what kind of action? what is the superior or great and glorious actions of the Bhagavan by which he is called as the one with a glorious action? Jagad Rakshana Lakshana. So the actions, his actions, which are characterized by or which is focused on the protection of the entire universe. So those actions are called as Satkritihi, noble, wise and glorious actions. So hence Bhagavan is denoted by the Nama Satkritihi, the one with glorious actions. The next Nama is Satta. Sajatiya, Vijatiya, Swagata Bheda Rahita, Anubhutihi, Satta. The one who is experienced as pure existence, bereft of differences within himself, of his own category and with other different categories. So Satta in the general sense means pure existence. Acharya here says it is not mere pure existence. So it is the pure, the experience of the pure existence, Anubhuti. So how is Bhagavan experienced by the realized souls? He is experienced by the realized souls as the one without any dualities or differences. What are all the kinds of dualities or differences that we generally perceive in our day-to-day transaction? Sajatiya Bheda, Vijatiya Bheda and Swagata Bheda. So these are the three general types of differences or the variations or dualities that we experience in our day-to-day transaction. So Sajatiya Bheda means normally we differentiate based on differences in characteristics of species or belonging to the same species. For example, there is a brown cow and there is a white cow. So they both belong to the same jati as that of the cow. But there is sajatiya bheda. Within the species, there is difference in characteristics of whiteness and also brownness. And hence we see sajatiya bheda exists. And then vijatiya bheda. So the difference between the cow and a lion. So the cow belongs to the category of cows and lion belongs to the category of lions. So they are different categories. So there also difference exists. So difference is perceived based on the difference in the species or category, and difference exists within the same category by virtue of the characteristics. And similarly, even within oneself, Swagata Bheda, within one entity also. So for example, take the example of the brown cow. So there also, though we call it as one cow, there are so many different limbs in that cow. There is the head, there is the feet, there is the tail, there are the udders. So all these are different from each other. So the head is not the feet. The feet are different from the udders, and the udders are different from the tail. So in this way, Swagata Bheda. So there are these many kinds of differences that we perceive in the world outside, whereas the experience of Paramatman is unitary, non-dual. There is neither Sajatiya Bheda, neither Vijatiya Bheda, nor Swagata Bheda. Paramatman is one single Satchidananda Swarupa, Ekameva Advitiyam. The Vedas also say that there is no interpersonal, interspecies, no such differences can be seen in the Bhagavan. So that is unitary, blissful consciousness experience. So that is pure experience, Anubhuti, denoted by the term Satta. The next Nama is Sadbhutihi. Sanneva Paramatma Chidatmakaha Abadhat. Bhasamanatvaccha Sadbhutihi. Nanyaha. Pratiter Badhyamanatvaccha. Na sannapyasat. श्रौतो यौक्तिको वा बोधः प्रपञ्चस्य विवक्षितः. सो द परमात्मन हु इज ऑफ द नेचर ऑफ कॉन्शियसनेस इज सत् एज हिज एग्जिस्टेंस इज नॉट रिफ्यूटेड. He also shines, no one else. All that is known in the form of world is refuted, either by the Vedas or by reasoning. Hence, they are neither existence nor non-existence. So, we see Sat Bhuti. Bhuti means a shining. Sat refers to pure existence. So the one who shines as pure existence, pure conscious blissful existence, he is Sadbhutihi, Chidatmakaha, of the nature. It's not mere existence, it is a conscious existence. And that existence, Abadhat, there is no refutation of that kind of existence and experience later. So that unchanging, unrefutable shining experience, so that that makes it shining and glorious. So that which is endowed with the unrefutable nature, so that is that which shines with such an unrefutable, unchanging nature is Sadbhutihi na anyaha. There can be nothing else like this. Previously also it was stated, ekameva advitiyam, there is one and only one Paramatman, that or one pure supreme consciousness which can be like this, and nothing else can match this kind of a purity in experience and glory. And that is the one which really exists. All others are mere appearances, inexplicable appearances. That is what is clarified by Acharya later when he says, pratiter badhyamanatvaccha nasannapyasat. So what happens is, all that we perceive in the world, pratiti, all that we see and experience through the sense organs, they are called as pratiti. They are all badhita, they get refuted either by the Vedas, shrautaha yauktikaha va badhaha, either by our own reasoning or by the Vedic injunctions or Vedic declaration, the wise Vedic declarations. The prapancha, the world that we experience, the world that we seem to grasp through our sense organs, they get refuted. So previously it was stated, ekameva advitiyam, there is only one real existence, one reality, that is the Paramatman. So this is a shrauta badha. So all the variations and the differences that we perceive are mere appearances. So this is the shrauta badha, or refutation from the Vedas about the diversity. Everything is abiding in this pure supreme conscious blissful nature. So that is shrauta badha, and yauktika badha also is there. By reasoning also we see that what we perceive gets refuted. What we perceive does not exist always, in the sense that in our own day-to-day experience. So when we go to the sushupti, we do not perceive, or we do not seem to be aware of the existence of the world outside. So either in the dream state, in and also in the deep sleep state, we do not see what we see in the waking state. So similarly, even in the dream state, what we see in the waking state is not seen. So hence, all that gets affected, all that get refuted, all that change, all that get modified. Whereas in all these three states, Jagrat, Swapna, Sushupti, what is that which abides? What is that which shines through all these states? It is awareness, it is consciousness. And hence, the unchanging, unrefutable Paramatman is constant. All that else, all else that which he is perceived, is neither existence nor non-existence. Nasanna pyasat means their experience is inexplicable. So as they are experienced, they seem to exist. So we may term it as sat. As they get refuted or they get changed, they are not perceived in an altered state, then they are non-existent. Hence, they exhibit the dual nature of existence and non-existence, so which is not constant, which is not eternal, and so anirvachaniya, which is nothing but maya. But the one clear sakshat aparoksha, the direct thing that we experience and in which we are always established, is the pure consciousness, that is Paramatman, and that is the one that really shines through all states, and hence it is called as Sadbhutihi. The next nama is Satparayanaha. Satam Tattvavidam Param Utkrishtamayanamiti Satparayanaha. The great refuge of the wise who know the truth. So Sat, Parayana are the two components. Parayana refers to Para, that is great, Ayana, refuge. So the great refuge or the great sanctuary or the ultimate abode to whom the Sat. Sat, the noble or the one who know the truth. Tattva Vidam. So those who know the Paramatman as a Satta and a Sadbhuti, as has been described previously, they are the Tattvavits. So those Tattvavits, they finally, those wise people, those knowledgeable people, so for them, what is the ultimate abode? For them, what is the ultimate sanctuary? That is Paramatman. He is hence Satparayanaha. The next nama is Shurasenaha. Hanumat Pramukaha Sainikaha Shaurya Shalinaha Yasyam Senayam Sa Shurasena Yasya Saha Shurasenaha. The one who has an army that includes valiant warriors like Hanuman. So thus far, previously we were speaking about the ultimate reality. So even in the relative realm, so to establish the dharma, Bhagavan is always ready. So that is indicated through this nama, Shurasena, Shura Sena. Sena is army, Shura is valiant. An army which is comprised of valiant soldiers, valiant warriors. So the one who is the lord of such an army, he is a Shurasenaha. It is indicated by Acharya as to who are those valiant warriors. We see Hanumat Pramukhaha, Hanuman, Sugriva, Angada, Gaja, Gavaksha, Gavaya, Sharabhaha, Gandhamadana. So many such valiant warriors, they existed in Ramasena. And hence the one who is the lord of such an army, he is Shurasenaha. And why does he have this army? To remove the evil and establish dharma. The next nama is Yadushreshtaha. Yadunam Pradhanatvat Yadushreshtaha. The prominent among the Yadus. So Yadushreshtha has two components, Yadu and Shreshtha. Shreshtha means the prominent, the important, the preeminent, and Yadu among the Yadu. Among the Yadu clan, we know that Bhagavan in his Krishna avatara was born in the Yadava Kula, and hence he is a Yadava, and he is not merely born in the Yadava Kula, he is the best among the ones who have born in the Yadava Kula, hence he is Yadushreshtaha. The next nama is Sannivasaha. Satam Vidusham Ashrayaha Sannivasaha. The one who is the refuge for the wise. So Sat Nivasaha. Nivasa, abode. Abode of whom? The Sat, the noble, or the wise, or the learned. Those who know the pure nature of the Paramatman. So previously also, the self-same concept was put forth through the nama Satparayanaha. So Satparayanaha and Sannivasaha mean the same, where the one who is the ultimate abode or ultimate refuge of the learned and the realized. The ninth nama is Suyamunaha. There are a couple of interpretations. The first one is Shobhanaha Yamunaha Yamuna Sambandhino. देवकी वसुदेव नंद यशोदा बलभद्र सुभद्रादयः परिवेष्टारः अस्येति सुयामुनः. The one who is surrounded by noble people like Devaki, Vasudeva, Nanda, Yashoda, Balabhadra, Subhadra, who are all connected to the river Yamuna. You know that the entire story of Krishna Avatara revolves around the banks of river Yamuna, and Bhagavan is also a Yamuna. Who is connected to the river Yamuna, and he is also surrounded by so many noble, virtuous, wonderful characters like Devaki, Vasudeva, Nanda, Yashoda, Balabhadra, and Subhadra. So hence, the one who is surrounded by people who are associated with the noble Yamuna river, he is Suyamunaha. The second interpretation is Gopaveshadhara Yamunaha Pariveshtaraha Padmasanadayaha Shobhanaha Hasyetiva Suyamunaha. Or the one who is surrounded by the one seated on the lotus, that is the Brahma, and others in the form of cowherds of Yamuna region. So previously, the Yamunas are those who are associated with Yamuna. So they were interpreted as Devaki, Vasudeva, Nanda, Yashoda. So those family members of Bhagavan in his Krishna Avatara were mentioned. Here, all the Gopalakas, the Gopas, they also belong to the Yamuna region, and Krishna was always surrounded by the Gopas and Gopis of that Yamuna region. And who were those Gopas and Gopis in reality? They were the incarnations of various divinities like the Padmasana and others. Padmasana means the one who is seated on the lotus, the creator, the Chaturmukha Brahma himself, and all other divinities, they manifested as the cowherds, the gopas and gopis, and they surrounded Bhagavan in his Krishna avatara, and they belong to the Yamuna region in that avatara of Bhagavan Krishna. And hence, here the Suyamunas refer to the gopas and gopis, so the common people. He was accessible to the common people also, and he is surrounded by the common gopas, the normal simple gopas and gopis. They were also Yamunas, and hence, so the one who is surrounded by noble family members and the one who is surrounded by the common people, the gopas and gopis of Vrindavana, so he is Suyamunaha. So thus, with these nine namas in verse 75, we have thus far seen 707 namas. Om Tat Sat Shri Krishna Arpanamastu.